Hello everyone, my name is Harshita Khirpar. I am a student of International Institute of Professional Studies, DAVV, currently pursuing M.Tech in IT. This video is a part of my assignment for the cloud computing subject under the guidance of Dr. Vivek Srivastava sir. In this video, we will be learning the basics of Google Firebase and connecting the Firebase to HTML form. So what is Google Firebase? Google Firebase is a Google-backed application development software that enables developers to develop iOS, Android, and web apps. It provides tool for what? To track analytics, report and fix app crashes, create a market, and experiment a product. Or we can say that Firebase is a product of Google, which helps developers to build, manage, and grow their apps easily. It also helps developers to build their apps faster and in a more secure way. No programming is required on the Firebase side, which makes it easy to use its features more efficiently. It provides services to Android, iOS, web, and Unity. It also provides cloud storage. And Firebase initially was an online chat service provider to various websites through API and ran with the name Involve. It got popular as developers used it to exchange application data like a game state in real time. Next is the uses of Firebase. First is the Firebase Analytics. It is a product that every scale type kind of developer must use. It gives such an in-depth view of your product that can help you grow and make your market strategies. And that is totally free. Second is Firebase Remote Config. It provides a personalized experience and much more. Totally depends on how you use it. Firebase Authentication. Third use is the Firebase Authentication. It can help you to implement the feature that a new website can dream of, like doing email SMS verification, letting users sign in, sign up. Fourth one is the Firebase database. It provides two types of database, Firebase real-time database and Firebase Cloud Firestore. Both of these databases are real-time savers. Next is the security of Firebase. It's real-time, quick to integrate into Android, iOS and web apps. Very easy for a new developer to learn. Data is written in documents which are contained in collections. And it supports a near unlimited number of both. And for the most part, as a standalone unit, it's extremely secure. Its data security is built on a system of programmable rules. We define which kinds of users can access which pieces of data. For example, you can say that a user can access anything stored under his ID, but nothing under anyone else. Now let's learn how to connect a Firebase to HTML form. First of all, we have to search Firebase on Google search and click on the first website. Now go to console. Then click on add project. Then enter your project name. I enter as contact form. That's it, and click on continue. Then disable this setting and click on create project. It takes few minutes, so wait. Now click on continue, and after that you have to click on real-time database. Click on create database, click on next, then click on enable. Enable and then click on rules. You give it the permission to the write option. Write it through and publish it. And after that, you have to click on Firestore database. Then click on Create Database. Then click on Next. Click on Enable. Then click on Rules. We have to edit these rules to give the permission of write as true. So read and write, allow write if true, then publish it. It publishes. Then click on project overview and click on this web icon and write your web name. I write it here, contact form details. And click on register app. Then if you use Node.js, so you stay on this point, use npm. But I use HTML CSS, so I use a script tag. After that, you have to copy this code in your VS code. So let's do it. So I copy the code. I write the file as mail.js and initialize my Firebase. So you can see that initialize Firebase. And after that, you have to reference your database. I wrote a code of referencing the database. So first of all, I will explain it. Firebase.database.ref. We have to write it. And here you need to write your database name, that is contact form. And it will return some object. So we need to get an object, contact form DB. After that, we need to get the contact from HTML file. This is my HTML file. And our name is contact form. So in mail.js, we write document.getElementById. And we are adding an event listener for that. And that event listener is going to submit. If the form is submitted, we need to call a function submitform. If the form is submitted, it will call the function submitform. So let's create. We create a function submitform. And in this, send an event into this. That is E. E.preventDefault. This will prevent the default action of your form. And after that, we will create a reusable code. I write a reusable code, which is here. I will explain it. Instead of writing the same line again and again, document.getElementById, we write a reusable code. Const getElementValue, and this id, send id as a parameter to this function. And we, let's return the value document.getElementById. We pass that id and dot value. We fetch that value from this id. This is the reusable code and we have all the values. So we need to save this message in our Firebase. After that, we get a name from here at line number 44. Where name equals to get element where. Call get element where function. And after that, this function returns the value of that particular element. Where email id. Again we call function get element where and pass email id. And Third one is the message content. We call the function getElement well and pass message content. And after that, we need to save our message to our Firebase. For this, we create one more function, save details. To save our details, we create a function save messages at line number 52, const save messages, and we pass three inputs as a parameter, name, email ID, message content. And after this, we need to push all these values into our database. So we push in contact form DB, which we create as a variable in reference our database, and we save it in a new variable called new contact form. After this, we need to set the values by using set method. So we use a set method, and we first of all we push these three values because we already create a reference for our database. So we use that contact form DB, and we use a set method. So this takes the object. So we need to send key and a value. Name is the key, and our value is also name from our parameter. You can see this. And other key is the email ID. And an email ID is the parameter. And third one is the message content, which is the key. And message content, you can see this. Message content is the value from our parameter. This save message push these three values to our database contact form in our real-time database. And getElement value, this function returns all values from their respective fields, and we get their respective variable name. This is name, email ID, and message content. We pass these variable names to our save message function. For that, we call it save message function and pass three parameters, name, email ID, and message content. Now we open our HTML file and we enter a data like name, email ID, and writing a message, testing a sample message, and we submit it. You see that a alert message is also shown, and in this real-time database you can see this, our contact form is created, and in this email ID, message content, and name is shown. And after that, I show you the alert message code. This is the code for reset form document.getElementById, and in this we write our database name dot reset. And after this, we have a code for enable alert. This is the code for enable alert, and this is the code to remove a alert. This alert message is removed after 3 seconds. So you can see this, that this is the name, email ID, and a message content. Submit, and you see an alert message, your message is sent. After 3 seconds, it will remove automatically. And in the database, you can see our data is stored, and you can remove from this as well, and also create a data from this by entering key and value. So that's it for now. We also store our data in real-time database by connecting a HTML form. So that's it. By connecting Firebase to HTML form. Thank you.